Ntabazi made the remarks during a media interview where she was clarifying the delegation led by Odrek Rabogo, which President Museveni sent to the USA to negotiate on Uganda's behalf, following threats made by the US to drop Uganda out of the Africa Growth and Opportunity Act. She noted that Rabogo was chosen because he's a presidential advisor on trade and industry.
I'm given a report, and the presidential advisor on trade matters and industry, Mr. Rabogo, who went with the team from PASAID, led by the minister here, Honorable Mwebesa, but I think eventually could not make it because of unavoidable circumstances.
She explained that Rabogo's team was given terms of reference by the president to clear misconceptions trending against Uganda regarding the Anti-Homosexuality Act.
No, the team was given powers, first of all, to deliver the message of His Excellency the President, secondly, to go into negotiations to meet with Ambassador Tai, who is the trade representative, of US to African countries, more especially Uganda, and also meet with, share these laws and see where is the mistake.
The United States recently announced ending eligibility for the African Growth and Opportunity Act, but the minister also faulted the US government for mixing issues of trade and human rights. The minister explains that Uganda has not tripped big from the U.S. AGOA market because the U.S. has been remanding Uganda to only export raw materials without adding value, saying this was already advantageous to Uganda.
If America insists that going for anti-homosexual and what, then we should start marrying woman to woman, man to man, then we shall do away with the market, because now the markets that we have, because what we are looking at in that market is our relationships, political relationships and those relationships, but real trade volumes that have shaped Uganda to the middle income status, that is not one of them.
According to Uganda Bureau of Statistics, in 2022 and 2023, Uganda exported goods worth $87.766 million. Earlier today, the White House announced the new sanctions to be imposed on Uganda, adding to the cocktail of other sanctions the country announced following the passing into law the Anti-Homosexuality Act 2023.
Already negotiations have started, because there were also the team from the leadership of African Continental Free Trade Area were also in those meetings. Now the U.S. was negotiating how it can also participate in and take advantage of that. So that means without us, they don't have any raw materials. There is nobody in the USA who plants coffee. Nobody. There's nobody in the USA who has cocoa plantations, who has tea, who has these things. So it is about vigilance of Africans.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.